All right, here we go. All right, this is the Money in the Bank live stream. We have comments. Now with comments. I'm watching it right here. If you want to sync up, I am at Roman Reigns walking in to the Money in the Bank match. I started a little bit late. The Money in the Bank match is first, which is very fucking odd. Because normally it's the semi-main if you have a title defense, if not the main event. What? It's also going to be very curious to see where they put Owen Cena, considering it was a fucking barn burner last time. All right, so here's what we are seeing in the chat room and what I totally agree with. We are in cash in watch. Yes. So what does that mean? That means that we are seeing a reaction, I guess, to the fact that there was a super long build that was very important last year. So maybe we want to go the other way and go against expectations. Of course, the dark horse, he said, understanding that it was the worst choice of words ever, is Kofi Kingston for a few reasons. Number one, he's over with the New Day. Number two, he is facing Brock Lesnar in the Japanese network special. So why didn't Kane just climb there? Kane's an asshole. So what you always hear about these matches is that you want catchers and you want flyers. Obviously, you have two exceptional flyers in Kofi Kingston and Neville. Yeah, and Ziggler. Although Ziggler's kind of found himself in fucking purgatory because I guess he was going to do a thing with Lana and Rusev, and now Rusev's on the shelf. Roman Reigns, the guy with another ladder. Roman Reigns, he's going to make it matter. Yeah, the Buck RI. I'm in love with the deconstructing the idiosyncrasies of Lillian Garcia's announcing on Cheap Heat lately. Aphex says a red arrow into an RKO out of nowhere. I don't think that human athleticism exists to make that happen. If that happens, I will be insanely delighted.
Now, this is definitely like the most soccer mom I ever get with fucking wrestling. Like, I just like, oh, you boys, don't hurt yourselves out there. Carl asks, is there any way that another superstar can run in and grab the briefcase? No. I don't think so. I mean, it's wrestling, so anything can happen, but... I don't know why this HDMI cord I used to have used to work, and now it doesn't, and that's really annoying. Kind of as annoying as my Wi-Fi in here, which is currently frozen. Oh, here we go. Well, I mean, I have nothing else to do since I can't watch wrestling. No. Now I just hit live and I see a new keyframe of now Kofi's looking skyward. God damn. Neville's so fucking good. Uh-oh. Oh, big mage sign. Look at that for the cheap Heat fans. Oh. Man, Roman kind of wrestling a little heelish, huh? Who's laughing when they push a fucking ladder into somebody? Feeling a little heelish. So... there is a big old rumor on the internet on Squared Circle's new inside dirt sheet savior, Falcon Arrow, who says that Reigns is not winning and that there will be a specific reason why Reigns does not win. Oh, jeez. Oh, Neville on Kofi. Oh, man. Do you think Cole's like sensitive about the fact that he has a from out of nowhere tick? RKO from unexpected times.
Oh, Jesus.
Nobody is happier that all of these flippy shit guys are up in the big leagues than Randy Orton. He looks like such a different performer when he's actually working with people that are as athletic as him or in the same neighborhood as athletic as him. Because you can do so many different RKOs. Punched in the thigh enough. That's a veteran move. The kitty cat paw. Mwah! Oh, by the way, now that I can actually do this shit, I mean. Ziggler. I mean, like, everyone always says that Ziggler gets injured too often, but, like, you know, at some point we gotta give him something, right? Oh, no. Oh, zigzag. Goddamn. Goddamn. Oh, Jesus. That's just fucking amazing no matter what. Ryan PDX, I don't think that's possible, a red arrow into an RKO. That's fucking insane. Oh, what did they do the 10 bell salute to Dusty at the beginning?
By the way, Kane pulling down Neville in a stunning metaphor of how the WWE has treated new talent over the past 15 years. A fun spot. Kane can still go, though. Jesus. Prof Pod, so, I mean, about the Superman punch being more important than a regular hit to the jaw, that is actually a legitimate MMA move. Like, that is something that people do in MMA. Uh-oh, everybody's ahead of me, trying to push live. New day. Agonizing. Uh-oh. Oh, man. Fun spot. DJM saying that the boos get louder and louder for Roman. I can't really hear. Oh. There's the booze. Well, look at that. Bray Wyatt face turn? Is it a Bray Wyatt face turn? When everybody cheers that you came in and did something? People are chanting, yes, yes, yes. Oh, God. Sheamus, come on. No. No. Nobody gives a fuck about Sheamus. DJM, I know. That's what I was saying before, that Reigns was not going to win because Falcon Arrow said it was a Wyatt feud. For real? Sheamus? I mean, if you're gonna give it to not Roman, why not give it to Kofi? I mean, would you be fearful, JBL, if you were the world champion? I mean, Sheamus loses a lot. Ashley says it's the hair. The Buck RI, is Sheamus getting pops live or something? I mean, Sheamus is one of those guys that at live house shows, he's kind of like Big Show or Kane or someone. Like he is more popular to see live, I guess. Like at the house show I went to, like Big Show and Kane were cheered like they were fucking the most over ever. I'd actually like Bray Wyatt to have a reason to attack people, though. Instead of just like,
hey, man, I was just sitting in the back eating Doritos, man. And I was like, why not? I mean, I'm kind of bored.
Ryan PDX, I would rather had any of those guys other than Sheamus. No, I don't know. Randy Orton would have been more boring. Kane would have been more boring. Roman Reigns, you know, would have been at least predictable. So, if anything, they gave us something unpredictable or just not particularly exciting. Kind of a sucker way for Neville to go out, though. I mean, listen, all we ever fucking wanted was heel Sheamus. Now we have super heel Sheamus. So I'm talking myself into it. I'm officially talking myself into it. I'm into super heel Money in the Bank Sheamus. Like, it's not the most exciting thing. We can, I mean, like, Neville would have been better. Kofi would have been better. And it is kind of always better as a heel device than it is a face device, right? We all know that. Eddie P, I feel like with Sheamus, it's going to go fast. Yeah, I hope so.
Is it?
Man. Tell you what. Paige. Looking for someone. This would be a pretty interesting place to debut Charlotte. Cha. DJ, my two least favorite divas. Hooray. What do you mean, Nikki and Paige? You're not on board with Paige? This would be really rad to see Charlotte here. It would be very, very fun to see Charlotte here. DJ, I'm never like Paige, even in the indies. She's like doll for me. The internet loves her, but I don't see it at all. What, you don't like Linkin Park? You don't like Brittany Knight? Ashley asked if Britney Wonder's more your style, DJM. I mean, the thing about Paige, though, is that she's crazy young. Like, she's, like, not 20 yet, right? Ashley's cooking right now. So, I mean, like... You know, the idea that Paige will only get better over the next 5 years. 22, yeah, she's fucking super, super young. Carl, wonder if there could be a WWE Hearthstone tie-in. Yeah, you know, there is the idea that, or no, what's it called? Dills made a WWE deck once. Seth Rollins was Dr. Boom because you have J&J Security pop up next to you. All right, what do you guys think? Do we see an NXT diva running? Yes or no for NXT diva running? I mean, aren't they in the same city? NXT ran Cleveland, Pittsburgh, Columbus, and this is in Columbus, right? The fucking cannonball, man. The cannonball is the move of its era. Everybody fucking does it. Everybody on the indies does it. Everybody in NXT does it. Everybody in WWE is starting to do it. Fucking, like, there is no more move that is fucking 2015 wrestling than the cannonball, or of the last 10 years.
DJM, and how appropriate that the guy that made the Cannonball famous is the most talked about guy in wrestling right now. Did the Rougeaus use it? I feel like that's where I first remember seeing it. Oh, man. We're really setting ourselves up. At this point, now I'm disappointed. Now I fantasy booked myself into a corner, and I'm disappointed if Charlotte doesn't show up. DJM, yeah, it might have been the Rougeaus because he did train him. For whatever reason, I kind of feel like that was the first time I saw that move, but I might be wrong. I might be just connecting dots that aren't there. Yeah, no, for those of you who don't know, Kevin Owens initially trained with Jacques Rougeau. Uh-oh. Little Four Horsemen reference. Paige is doing NXT, I thought. There's no way she'll win tonight. No, she's not doing NXT. Paige's main roster. Paige is about as big of a star as you get on the main roster right now in the Diva division. Yeah, she hadn't been in NXT in over a year. Oh, not NXT, I meant Tough Enough. NXT means next without the E, but it's a different, I mean, don't think about it. Yeah, I mean, that would make sense if she's doing Tough Enough, but I don't know what that schedule is. I mean, it could just be another day off, right? Especially if it's being shot in Orlando and she lives in Orlando. I mean, the only reason why she wouldn't have the strap put on her is because she wouldn't be able to make house shows, but that doesn't seem to be the case. Oh, Counting Coup says she isn't a trainer. I know Billy Gunn is the ass man. By the way, little heads up, that one-man show at Nerdtacular, we're going to get the supersized version of the Billy Gunn Ass Man theme song rant. I've been writing it out. I think it's pretty funny. They showed the back twice. Incoming schmaz. All right, so here we go. Chris Jericho is the host with Hulk Hogan, Daniel Bryan, and Paige as judges, with Billy Gunn, Booker T, and Lita to serve as trainers, coaches. The show will air live from the WWE Performance Center in Orlando, home bases of the WWE's NXT developmental territory. Hulk Hogan and Paige are doing it because they live there. Daniel Bryan's doing it because they got to keep him fucking active while they find out whether or not he can ever wrestle again because he's got a book to sell. I like that as a better submission move than the PTO, by the way. PTO usually just takes too long. Counting coup. If you can't wrestle, I'd love Brian as the commish. Yeah, I mean, maybe. I mean, if people want that, it is a credit to the fact that he's had his mic skills come around. Oh, by the way, if you want to talk about E3 shit, then go ahead and talk about E3 shit. Hashtag E3 in the chat room will bring you there. Uh-oh. DJM's ahead. Twin Magic's coming. I'm still watching. Paige is up. Oh, no. Nikki follows her. A fucking dusty finish. God damn it. Well, is it a dusty finish if there's no other ref? It's just the idea of the babyface getting the pop and then having it reversed, right? Oh, that's funny. Yeah, Lou. So that is technically a dusty finish, right? I mean, so what? Do we get Charlotte on Monday? Like, what the fuck's happening here, people? How do you tease that whole fucking angle and then not do anything? Like, that's not even building. That's just, like, boring. Like, okay. Come on, Nikki! Well, the Divas would be the final thing. I mean, listen, as much as Neville has gotten a push, as much as Kevin Owens has gotten a push, the final frontier is if NXT can change Divas wrestling on the main roster, right? Eddie P, World Class Championship Wrestling for life. The old Sportatorium. Yeah, that's kind of boring.
Oh.
This is actually a really good idea. This swerved show. If even just because there is at least a tradition of like elaborate and ridiculous pranks in professional wrestling. I don't know why they decided to go with one weird fucking, you know, kayfabe term and swerve instead of rib, which is exactly what they're called. Tomato Meister says, Captain Q, either they're going to have Nikki break AJ's record or Charlotte will show up to be, I assume, Paige's partner for a Bella's feud. AJ's out of here. All right, everybody, this is the time where I go and grab some wine. Because this is a boring match. And so we'll talk about anything you want while this boring match is going on.
Hey, what's the party app? No, it's fine.
Oh, wait, hold on. All right, so here we go. Let's go to candles. Oh, it didn't work. Yeah, shit didn't work. I watched a Tough Enough special with The Miz and Ryback on it last week. Ryback is such an awesome dork. I kind of feel like they really left money on the table with that Ryback-Bray feud because I wanted to see peak Ryback for me, face Ryback, is the fact that you know somebody who works out a lot that's very sensitive. Like, he's the one that, like, you make fun of him too much and he can't take it. Like, we all know this. It's a very modern idea, and I feel like we root for him. We can root for him. Like, he's just a little sensitive. Why did they give away the shell shock on Raw? That's crazy. Like, why not save that for the pay-per-view? I mean, because where do you go for the finish for this match? But I mean, like, Ryback is all about redemption and positivity. It's hard not to like that. Plus, it's fun when he wrecks shit. But he's got to be a dork. He kind of has to be somebody that cries. Man. I would be delighted if this match only went 5 minutes. That would be really, it would make me happy. Can somebody freeze frame?
what they were playing on their iPads. Hey, by the way, Andrew Zarian's in the chat. Andrew, if you want to call in, you can we can talk wrestling if you want. By the way, I'm going to Ring of Honor next week with Mr. Andrew Zarian. Fucking back-to-back wrestling events. I'm going to be Ring of Honor on Friday, and then I'll be at Joey Images' final match ever in Moosic, Pennsylvania. Yeah, I don't know if Andrew's coming out to music, but I am. So the one thing you could always say about these kind of matches is that, like, live, it is always interesting to see two brontosauruses fucking slap bellies. Well, I'll tell you what. We've shown the first signs that this fucking computer is mortal. Skype is a tremendous resource hog, and... opening.
Yeah, I realized that, even though it was saying I was only using like
26-27%. Well, yeah, Skype chokes though. So like, look, I opened Skype. Oh, it did. I think we should have Big Show win just so we can have it be, you know, fucking 2004 again. Nikki Bella, Sheamus, the Big Show. All the stars are out for the WWE. Now Ryback cheating toward the camera. Oh, man, this internet fucking killing me. How do you not, I mean, Ryan PDX, I've actually thought that all the pay-per-views have been pretty good lately. This is probably the worst one that we've had so far. That's fine, because now we're in SummerSlam season. All right. So we're going to see I can't get... I can't get this on fucking wired internet because... Cha. All right, here we go. Let's go to system preferences, network. USB Ethernet. Cable unplugged.
Come on, that.
Why isn't this working? I mean, I could always show it here on the computer. All right, everybody, guess the finish. Wow, an Inception blah? WWE's doing Inception blahs? Ice Swarmer, if Owens loses clean, it throws everything he's done in the trash and taints his match with Samoa Joe. I don't think so. I mean, in kayfabe,
he is not necessarily 100% better than Cena. I mean, I think the biggest thing that Owens needs to do is just tear down the fucking the house with fucking with Kevin Owens. I mean, like, or Kevin Owens got to tear down the house with fucking with Cena again. I mean, to be honest, like, the finish, I'm excited to see what it is, but the match is more what I'm excited for.
What?
Oh. DCTV 90505. Yep, we're watching wrestling.
I'm excited to see John Cena get back to doing the open challenge, though. It's odd that we're doing another match without the titles on the line, though.
You're holding it backwards, John. That reminds me when Ted Turner called Vince and said, "I'm in the wrestling business," and Vince must have went, one, da fuck, and two, good for you, I'm in the sports entertainment business. I mean, fucking, yes, and Vince will tell you that whenever anything is brought up about fucking Ted Turner. DJM, no, I agree. And by the way, Kevin's going to kill it because John Cena's great. John Cena is G-R-E-A-T in all caps, underline bolded, great. I love the difference in octaves for the cheering. It's like 5 octaves higher for John. Lou, seen as this era's Hulk Hogan, Ric Flair, insert big company guy here. No, I mean, he's more Ric Flair than Hulk Hogan in terms of ring work, though. He's great. And that is true. DJM makes a very good point. He's put over more guys than both Flair and fucking Hogan combined. all of your problems with Cena are with the creative department, and by the creative department, I mean Vince. Like, that's true. Yeah, that's a very good point. People are pointing that out that Flair put everyone over. That's true. It's more Hogan. Hogan was the one that was kind of a dick.
Sure. Jury, they're doing an NXT mixed tag match. I haven't. There hasn't been one on the main roster lately. I can't remember the last time they did one. I think they did Tyson, Cesaro, and Natty versus Los Matadores and El Torito, which is just fraught with a lot of problems when it comes to, you know, equating a woman to an animal. But yeah, no, NXT is doing Carmella, Enzo, and Cass versus Alexa Bliss, Blake, and Murphy. Oh, man. Oh, Wi-Fi McGillicuddy. I can, but then it'll be on the board. Well, yeah, I guess I'm not playing anything on the board right now. Yeah, fuck it.
We're playing music through your iPad.
Yeah. You're smart. Oh, no, wait, I have to run it through the board, right? Oh, I guess I could unplug.
Are you playing any sounds from your desktop?
No, but I can't. If it's running through the board, I have to unplug it into the speakers directly. Yeah, also, this is running way slow. Yeah, holy shit. DJM called it. Owens is wrestling with a baby face for this crowd.
Carl, I don't think the Rusev's injured, so I don't think he's going to fuck with anything. DJ, Rusev is injured, broken ankle, and also a broken heart. Lana and Rusev? Yeah, they are, but they're on screen broken up. Jastin, it's nice to see Cena start using more than five moves. Has the thing ever been that Cena only uses five moves, or that Cena has the five moves of Doom? Because five moves of Doom are different than only having five moves. Yes, Nash had four moves. Squisher. Side slam, hair flip. DJM, it's five moves of Doom. It's the sequence of moves that lead to your finisher. So, like, Shawn had five moves of Doom. Bret Hart had five moves of Doom. I only have one move, Tondagasa, and I helped. It's shake and bake, and I helped. Fuck, God damn it. I think part of it is this Wi-Fi, though. Like, because I feel like it dips out even on, like, cell phones and shit. Like, right now, I can't load anything on my cell phone, but plugged in, I'm good. Guys, look at this. A little fucking vegan food. It's the way you fucking... Oh, Jesus. Hi, Germ 24.
Yes, please.
All right. By the way, yeah, so we have a carrot salad with corn on the cob and a tofu barbecue salad. Tempeh barbecue salad, sorry. Oh, geez. Oh, my God. God damn it. This fucking Wi-Fi. I missed a fucking Cena Canrana. Ice Worm, I mean, listen, that's another topic entirely. You want to know what? I probably need to download the driver for this Razorfish thing. Did you steal my knife?
Oh, did you still need it?
Yeah.
Sorry, I thought you were using it for the butter and that was it.
I'm gonna cut this sandwich in half.
He is. Oh, come on.
Kevin Owens.
All right, you guys are all way ahead of me because I'm not hitting live because I don't want to miss any of this. Kevin Owens just hit the fucking the semi-fisherman suplex thing. The package superplex. Yeah, it's a fisherman suplex from the top rope. So now we're in a STFU. Oh my God! Holy shit! That was an insane fucking Yoshi tonic. Thank you. I mean, a bit of a anticlimactic finish. All that being said, that was fucking amazing. The only question is just where do you go from there? I mean, you could. That's not going to happen, though. All that being said, I like last. I like the Elimination Chamber's match just a little bit better. Scotch. But this showed more from Cena. Holy shit. Who knew fucking... who knew he had that in him? This fucking internet.
Is it always this bad when you
do
it?
There we go. Apron power bomb. Man, this fucking... God damn, this stupid fucking internet.
Such suspense. Wow.
So, I mean, I guess the question is, that's great. Anytime you're laughing maniacally after saying, get the stretcher, you know you're a bad guy. It's commercial time.
Was that an adequate sandwich?
Great.
There's not even an answer.
stuff, which is
That was good.
Yeah, it was actually supposed to have a ton of sesame seeds in it too, but I forgot we didn't.
Yeah. They're dating in real life. Tell you what, Dean looks good with the championship. He looks believable. Hell of a promo. Hell of a promo by Dean.
I think only two more matches.
Hour.
I mean, it usually ends at the hour. So probably another hour. So here's what is amazing about this video, and really it's the most amazing thing about Dusty Rhodes, is the breadth of his influence. Because there's nobody that was as big as him that has the influence with, like, the generation that's going to be headlining WrestleMania in 5 years, in 10 years. Like, it's not crazy to think that Finn Balor will headline WrestleMania in 5 years, right? And, like, Dusty Rhodes had a huge part of his existence. Dean Ambrose gave him the name Dean Ambrose. Hey, buddy. Well, announcer in WCW, of course, NWA was probably where he had his best matches as a wrestler. Yeah, Dusty Rhodes, just insane. DJM, I love Xavier, mostly because he's me, but still. I mean, I don't know, man. I don't know what your POG collection looks like. Clap Nation. So they have this clap. Here, you'll. So they have this clap, New Day rocks, as everybody chants, New Day sucks. Would you mind throwing that in the kitchen? Or put that there. Oh, man. DCTV 90505. I don't get it. What are heels? Heels are bad guys.
Or shoes.
Also shoes. Although bad guy wrestlers are not called pumps. So in the parlance of professional wrestling, heels are bad guys and good guys are faces or baby faces. Biggie is so good. No, Stone Cold would not say he stomped a mud hole in him. JR said he stumped a mud hole in him. Ice Swarm. Jerry, where was this Big E when he was IC champ?
I mean, a lot of it's what they tell him to do. And you know, performers evolve. You know, if you looked at like what Big E was doing on like Vine and Instagram and stuff like that when he was IC champion, he was very funny.
Man, we had such a good streak there with the internet. Ice Worm, stop it. Does Darren Young ever get horny in a match? Come on. Well, because he's gay. He's out and gay.
Now that being said, Darren Young makes, you know, quite a few gay references himself.
Which one is Darren?
The one on the bottom. Oh, shit. A little rock bottom. It's interesting because now I don't remember Titus just wrestling with Mongo McMichael's moveset, but dude, that Big E fucking off the apron spear just always looks fucking insane. It's like a bus careening. Oh, come on. Really? Why would you... Why would you undercut New Day like that? I guess New Day doesn't need the titles. I guess that's what they're thinking. For the rematch at SummerSlam, PTP is a babyface team, has a few more rivals. Yeah, I guess. New Day will bitch about it.
Yeah,
How is Sheamus on a roll? Like, if anything, Sheamus scored a win, right? But he lost against Ziggler. He lost it in the Intercontinental Title Elimination Chamber match like 5 minutes ago. Oh, he does? The Deebs does? Oh.
Cena, why not let a pissed off Roman Reigns call him out?
But the loss by Roman, it makes me think Ambrose is going to win tonight. WWE is in love with the Shield, but anybody who wins in the main event is the Shield going over, right? That's an amazing face. That's an all-time face.
Man, we just had the best freeze frame on Dean Ambrose in a 1994 fucking like solo album cover. Dude, Dean, I'll tell you what, if this is a trial run for Dean, I think he's done fantastic. I think he's done great. Hey, Deebs. DJ, I might totally agree with you. I just want to say I'll be fine with all three members of the Shield rotating in and out of the main event for the next 10 years. Yeah, I agree. Man, I just want them to fade to Dean drinking in the back. Chip-ya-cha! Oh, I realize why they gave the fucking primetime players the belts, because they're going to fucking have them feud with what's it called? With the Reapers, with the old Wyatt family. Unless that fucking Dudley Boys Wyatt family thing turns out to be true. Oh, look at that. The WWE special event. Not pay-per-view. Special event. Because they used to sell it on pay-per-view, and now they also sell it on pay-per-view, but primarily they push buying the network to get them.
Oh, man. I'll show them all. It's from Hearthstone. Which one? The one with the beard?
Yeah, you know, beards.
Nice.
Beards are nice.
Yeah, I agree. Way hotter.
Yeah.
What's Dr. Bird's opinion of the show so far? He's actually a big New Day mark. He's real pissed off. He already shit on the floor.
Yeah.
Oh, I figured out why that mic wasn't working.
What?
It wasn't plugged into main.
Oh.
Oh, I guess maybe they just did Money in the Bank first, so they didn't have two ladder matches right next to each other. They wanted to get the ladder matches away from each other. Although that didn't really stop them last year when they did a championship ladder match with six guys and Money in the Bank ladder match with six guys, like back to back, basically. But maybe they didn't like it then.
I also like his Cruella de Vil hair.
Yeah. Artsman said, Jerry, the matches were separated last year, too. Yeah, but one wasn't first, was it? The briefcase match was early last year. Yeah, but not first. They didn't open it, did it? For whatever reason, I remember it being in the middle. Oh, briefcase match was first. Oh, first in order of the ladder matches. Yeah, no, I don't think that it was first in on the card though. No biting.
Jury, last year the briefcase match was 4 and the title match was 8. Yeah, I remember it being in the middle. The flying push. Teasing some ultra violence. Oh, Jesus. I think we are going to see some insane Seth spot, like a Phoenix Splash or something.
Doctor is not interested.
Oh, jeez. Oh!
Yeah, I know, Doctor. It's not real light head slam.
Watch this.
Bionic elbow.
That's a hell of a move, Daddy. That's the kind of move that would headline a sold-out Omni in Atlanta, Georgia.
Yeah, guys, they don't cut themselves with blades anymore. Not in the WWE. And to be fair, listen, man, if you ever want to see fucking blood in wrestling, there's plenty of fucking history of that. And there's fucking promotions that still do it. So, you know, it's fine that we have one that doesn't.
They are the slowest ladder crawler.
Oh, yeah. DCTV 90505, blood capsules are harmless enough. For whatever reason, blood capsules are kind of frowned upon in wrestling. As theatrical as it is. Kind of like the pace of this match. Like, it's definitely selling the brutality like you kind of have to for a match like this. But you know they're going to turn it up and get fucking wild. But I'm glad they didn't start there. They didn't start going as fast as you know they can.
I don't like ladder matches.
Why is that? Well, there is plenty of that.
Slow ladder. Like, it's none of it feels as realistic as some of the other stuff.
Sergeant Bevan, what happened to the three-level Hell in a Cell thing? I believe WCW did that. Oh, this is great. So they're basically selling this as Dusty Rhodes versus Ric Flair. So one of the greatest. But his greatest feud of his life was against Ric Flair, another legendary wrestler, where Dusty Rhodes was always the good guy and Ric Flair was always the bad guy. And so with Dean kind of signaling the bionic elbow, which was Dusty Rhodes' finisher, and him doing the figure four leg lock on the outside of the ring, which was Ric Flair's, they're kind of like signaling that like this is what these are the archetypes they're playing to. Yeah, this is like 70s as fuck. Hey, Flair wasn't always the bad guy when he fought his suit. It deserved it. It's a good point. And he wasn't the bad guy to all those ladies. You know, he had a Space Mountain. It was the oldest ride, but had the longest line. Woo! Man, he fucked a lot of people. He was old and he fucked a lot of people. Okay. That's why he called his dick Space Mountain.
I don't think that's true anymore, though. I'm just saying they're better.
No, apparently. All right, so his daughter's a wrestler now, right? Ric Flair. And I heard an interview with her, and she said that Ric Flair really loves Sex and the City. Like, he cries watching Sex and the City. Oh! Double stomp. Yeah, Tomato Meisters points out that you no-sold. You no-sold my Ric Flair joke.
I mean,
or explanation.
It wasn't that funny.
I mean, I was just explaining. Listen, I didn't make the all joke.
Right, all right.
See, look, you no-sold me.
Yeah. Maybe I should have heard the proposal, too.
Oh, jeez.
I mean, they should take up rock climbing classes. They'd do a lot better at that.
Jesus. Yeah, you know, I mean, I don't know. I love the pace of this is so fucking 70s. Which, when they fucking turn it up. Prof Pod telling fucking Mick Foley all snows jokes. Jas, then, does she like wrestling? I think tolerate. Would tolerate be a... Like, their Hood Slam is probably the only thing that you would legitimately say that
yeah,
you enjoy.
I like Hood Slam, but Hood Slam's not really wrestling.
Hood Slam's real.
Hood Slam's real. That's
yeah.
The
man, we missed a hell of a show last night. I was seeing some of the video of it.
Yeah. Were they all in cosplay?
Yeah. They had the Super Stoner Brothers. So they were in Mario and Luigi outfits. They had... Assassin's Creed. Kano came out.
What did Link dress as?
I don't know.
I was too tired to go to that.
Yeah.
We've been too busy.
Well, we were also, like, we had to fucking run that computer, like, yeah, just before we, like, did a full day of streaming today.
Yeah. What does kayfabe mean?
Kayfabe is the reality in which, like, you believe in.
Yeah, but Hood Slam says it's real.
It is real,
that's
yeah.
The difference.
Oh, Jesus. See, now what's different about this, what makes this 70s as fuck, is that they're telling a physical story. Like, every move that they make in the ring builds upon it. So every move that Dean is making,
he can't make with a lot of leg pressure because he's gotten his leg worked over the entire match. See, and that would normally be like, you know, a big explosive move for him, but he can't do it because he's on one leg. Which, by the way, is going to make his fucking middle rope Kickstarter clothesline look way better because it looks like shit when he looks healthy. Hey, Tenser. What's up, homie?
He's gonna break down into that the Thriller dance, the way you just shuffling.
Oh, boom. Robodashi, what's up, homie? Wrestling thing is coming to an end. We've had a fairly mediocre pay-per-view with two exceptional matches. One where an old school guy wrestled with a bunch of new school moves, and another where two super new school guys fucking are basically wrestling for the NWA championship fucking for Crockett Promotions. Lillian's got to get the hell out of the way of this Chip-ya-cha match. Wait, why does Dean want him, like, let Seth run away? Robodashi says, sup, jury, don't usually tune into this one. Ashley looks super excited.
So excited. I hope that your Florida swamp man just goes and gets it.
No, he already fucked it over somebody.
Oh.
Earlier, yeah.
And Dr. Bird flies to Columbus.
I think so. So now here we go. Here's the big start of the big... the big comeback. Now Dean's out of sight, out of mind, with no fucking legs under him. Everyone's screaming for Dean to get up. Oh my God, something amazing happens. Carter is president. Oh, here we go.
Reach up and grab it.
Whoa!
Boom! Wow, and that one doesn't look wood. A lot of times they'll bring out a wood one. Oh, no, it does kind of look wood. They'll paint one wood one. Does it? Yeah, it looks a little woody.
That's what he said.
Jury, why would they paint a wood ladder? Because wood ladders break and metal ones don't.
More give?
Well, it just snaps. Like, metal ladders do not snap under that much pressure. They might bend, but, like, it's not, like, impressive. Ugalog, they could go full 70s if they announced the time remaining in the match. That would be fucking Dusty Rhodes if they did a 40-minute fucking Broadway. Oh. Come on. Fucking internet. Yeah.
Maybe Doctor chewed through all the cables.
No, something's fucked up. I think it's the router. I gotta reset it. Nice. Warriors are going to win. Greetings. That's actually amazing.
You should have got the earlier face with the sunglasses.
Yeah. Come on. Dean is struggling.
He can't win because he's taken too long.
He's got to do it on one leg. Oh, Jesus. Why do they still have CRT monitors? Also, DCTV 57727 says a monitor screws over Ambrose again. At least this one didn't explode like a fucking Looney Tunes cartoon. Oh. If fucking Sheamus ruins this fucking match, I will literally, like, hate him forever. This match is a fucking work of art. Seth, with as slow of an ascent as he was to change the passwords on his Instagram account.
See, I got that joke.
Thank you. You didn't know sell that one joke. No.
Sounds funny. Yeah, well, I laughed. It's time to stand.
It is. No, I know. Yeah, he's doing the kitty paw to fucking save time. Dude, they're building Dean into a hell of a fucking baby face. Oh! Yeah, look, you can see it.
Yeah.
You can see the wood. Oh, exploder power bomb. Oh! Oh.
You know, I just gotta think after a match that long when he keeps, like, putting his face in his balls, he's gotta smell awful.
Oh, I mean, like, the entirety. I mean, like, you've been right next to a fucking wrestling ring for Hood Slam. Like, if it weren't for the pot, it would smell fucking terrible. He does. He's singing because of the Warriors won. He's a big basketball fan. Sit down, powerbomb. And Dean is dead. And if Dusty was still alive, he would be announcing and saying, well, you gotta question why Seth Rollins would put himself in such danger with a sit-down power bomb. Oh, fuck. Oh, I love this. This is fucking old school, like 70s heat. They're just booing the heel because he's too violent. Hey, look, guys, in a WWE match, they're booing the bad guy and fucking cheering the good guy. That's crazy.
They're lowering it? No. Oh. Hold my hand.
Oh, man. Yeah, in a grab for the ball, does the receiver or defensive back have it on the 50-50? All right, come down.
What? I was just going to go get a booted up.
All right. Wouldn't be a tribute to Dusty Rhodes if the good guy won. There is only one currency in professional wrestling, and that is optimism. Optimism in the face of absolute defeat. You always want Dean to win. You always want the babyface to win, even when the fucking bad guy continues to kick his ass. You build. Now, fucking WWE has the memory of a goldfish, so this will probably build to nothing. But I would have loved if they held the sound, held the music. Like made the refs argue with each other and shit. Dr. Boom won with no boom bots. That's true. Well, and also they got to put this feud on ice because Brock Lesnar comes back tomorrow night. So it was a good test run. Good test run for Dean. I think he showed it off, man. That was great. That was an amazing match. Great finish, man. I do really, really wish that they would have had the two refs argue with each other for a little bit and then the announcement. This is 70s as fuck, too.
This is a great finish. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of WrestleStream. Thank you guys so much for watching with me. Jasmine, Brock is a terrible pro wrestler. No fucking charisma. Number one, I'd actually disagree. I think he's got a fair amount of charisma. Number two, that's why they put Paul Heyman with him. Yeah, all right. Tomorrow, live and direct, we have Jerry Moore. NSFW, fuck NSFW. Night Attack live with me from Indianapolis, Ohio. Yeah. Bing bong ding dong. I think I'm doing TMS on Wednesday. And that's about it. All right. Well, guys, thanks again. This is... here, you want to know what? Let's... let's go ahead and do this right.
At St. Jude,
oh, come
families
on.
Never receive a
oh, come
treatment.
On. Enough of this shit. Folks, yeah, follow me at Justin R. Young, Jury Stone. Oh, here we go. Come on, daddy! Live and direct from Oakland, California, I'm Justin, that's Dr. Bird, she's Ashley. We will see y'all.